at you with another video here. I thought I'd just do a little bit of explaining, really. I've had tons of comments on my videos, and some of them are just a bit too annoying. I just thought I'd explain myself. I'm 16 years old, and that explained the reason why everything's in my bedroom. I can't drive, and that's the main misconception about me on my channel, is I make a lot of bass videos and other miscellaneous videos about bass boosts and music editing and all that. But I've been getting tons of comments saying, oh, why is it in your home? Why ain't you got a car? Why aren't you doing this? And it's been starting to really bug me. I'm 16, I am going to be able to drive this year. Whether I drive this year is another matter. Oh god, you can see my Big Bang Theory poster. Anyways, a little off topic, but yeah, I just thought I'd go through and explain what I've got, how I'm running things, why I'm not running it very well. It's not safe, if you can put it that way, but that'll be all explained. But you know, you gotta work with what you got really. I mean, I'm 16, I live in a home with 5 other people, and I can't have it loud all the time. It's just not going to benefit me if I got louder. I don't want to keep wasting my money on bigger amplifier, bigger subs, you know, bigger setup. It wouldn't be very beneficial, because I can hardly turn the system I got up now without getting told off, and it would just be the biggest waste of money ever. So when I get a car, it will be a lot different. I think you'll just find that I'll definitely be making a bigger system and probably expand on it. And my videos will become more rangeable, from bass maybe to car customization, because I like cars, obviously. I like them. And my dream is to become a car mechanic. So that's all changing this year. This year is going to change a lot for me. I've got to go to college, apprenticeship. Maybe if I can't get an apprenticeship, I'm just going to stick in college. But you know, I just gotta go with that. So I might as well just show you the system in itself. Got a load of crap on my sub box. I've got plimsolls, chuck them on the floor. I've got my school shoes, chuck them on the floor. What's this? I don't even know what this is. I don't even know what you can class this as. I think it's called a Scart Lead, but I don't need that. Now, I've been working on this little cool emblem at school. It's nowhere near finished. It's not in my intention to actually finish it, because I can't be bothered. But oh well. But we'll get onto the system itself. Well, like I said, it wouldn't be beneficial for me to get bigger and better subs, but these do the job. I like these subs. The box in itself is tuned to 27 hertz, very low, but it does a job. Right, these subs are Bass Face, made by Bass Face. These are 12 inch subwoofers. I got 2 of them. I don't know how much I'm powering it by, but I'll explain that all later. I've got 3 chrome ports. They go back about 14 centimeters. Yeah, that tunes it down to 27 hertz. And we've got the plexiglass window where you can just see the 3 ports and the 2 subwoofers and the wiring. The window is 0.5 centimeter thick, and now you may be thinking, how the hell isn't that rattling or vibrating? But in actual fact, it's very sturdy. It doesn't vibrate. It's quite solid, to be fair. And going on to the lights are a really cool feature, I think. You can't really see them at all, because they're hidden on this side of the wall, so you can't see it at all, which is handy. Nope, you still can't see them. It comes with a little cool remote, if I can freaking find it. Of course I can't find it. It's no. Oh, there it is, found it. Yeah, so it comes with this little cool remote where you can just change the colours of the box. And now I can't change. Oh, wait, I'm pressing the wrong button. There you go, green, blue. You can get purple, you get light blue, yellow, orange. You can get all sorts of colours. You can make it flash and crap like that, which I highly recommend these lights. I wouldn't know what they're called. I think they're made by SMD. They're off of eBay for about £12. They do the job, just holding up on the side of this wall here, and it lights the box up nicely. Yeah, Up there, we just have the two 6.5-inch mids, and then you got the thing that's like 1.5-inch highs there. They did the job. I mean, I got perfect bass to like tweeter ratio. It's decent for what I need right now. The subs in themselves are smooth. They haven't gave me any problems except when the wires get rattled loose. But apart from that, I'd seriously recommend these subs. I mean, I got these for, I think, £25 each off eBay. Now, you're probably thinking, why don't you just get something more expensive? Like I said, it wouldn't benefit me. There'll be absolutely no point. But apart from that, I like the system as a whole. Now, I've had this system, this, our stereo, I can't really call it head unit yet. But this is just a Sharp SW340H. My camera's gone laggy. This is a phone. I ain't got a proper camcorder at the moment. Yeah, basically, it's got two channels for the mids and highs, which power them speakers. And then I got like a mono block, like a sort of amp. So it's just one channel, and that's powering these subs. And I think it's this amp can only be on the mono block, only about 8 ohms it can be powered down to, and I'm powering it down to 2 ohms, and I know you guys are probably going to go, why are you doing that? That's not safe. But by the time it has a safety cutout on it, and which is, I don't care really. I mean, it gets up to about volume 14, and as soon as you hit like 16 or something like that, it'll cut out because of the bass. Sorry for the laggy camera, but by the time I get it up to that volume, I get told off anyway. So like I said, it wouldn't be beneficial for me to get a better amplifier and get it all wired up properly, and it's just going to cost money and for stuff I really don't need. And you're probably going to moan at me saying, oh, you really really need to stop doing that, it's like quite dangerous. But like I said, it's got a safety cutout on it. If it stops it, I just leave it because it's getting warm, and that's about it. Apart from that, the subs don't get warm at all after a long long period of time of playing bass, and that's about it, really. I mean, these speakers up here, they do the best. They are brilliant little speakers. I like them. They do punch out a lot of bass. I mean, I have a stock stereo. Would never, ever compete to this. I mean, this is the stock subwoofer that came with the stereo, and it's just an 8-inch little sub. It does the job. It's a good sub, don't get me wrong, but it would never ever compare to these, and I don't think I'd ever go back. I mean, this is unplugged at the minute because I don't want to wire down the stereo to an even lower ohm load than it already is. But getting off topic for a bit, I used to get my music, because I got this tablet, and it's called a Pipo Max M9. It's like, okay, it comes from China, but apart from that, it's a good tablet. I give it that. It's quite good. I mean, the bass on it is really good, smooth. It's got quad core, 2 gigs of RAM. It's fast. That's what I need it for, and it does the job, and I like it. And then when I'm not using Skype or anything, I use my computer for the job too. I'm not going to go through the details of that. It'll just bore you to death. But yeah, like I said, this is the system I'm rolling with right now. Remember, I am getting a new setup soon. Like, I don't know what I plan to, because my first car obviously isn't going to be immaculate, it's not going to be big, it's not going to be fast, it's not going to have a big boot, and that's the problem. No big boot equals no big speakers. So I've got to work with what I've got, and then we'll just go from there, guys. I mean, this is what I've got for now. I just hope you enjoy it. And I know I'm powering it too low, but the subs are being powered at 4 ohms, which is their recommended. But the amp's being powered to 2 ohms, which is not good. But, you know, I just leave it. It does the job. And sorry for the laggy camera. Like I said, it's my phone. And I hope you enjoyed this video of me just explaining everything. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching, guys. Oh, and yeah, this is 3/4-inch wood. That's all I wanted to add. 3/4-inch. That's it. And that's good. It's held together with PVA. Strong, doesn't flex, doesn't do anything. And I hope you enjoyed it, guys. So I'll see you later.